Hi friends.
Namaste.
How's life? Hope this finds you great spirits.
Pura vida.
Pura vida.
Did you see my stories that I posted on stories today? That was such a beautiful moment. This morning I was swimming in the pool and suddenly this vulture just kind of landed like right in front of me. I had to stop not to kind of run into the vulture.
Well, and on the edge of the pool,
at the
not
edge
on the
of
water.
Pool, no, yeah, at the edge. And then and then I just looked at it, and they smell really bad. But anyway, I looked at it, and suddenly the two birds...
No.
Okay, tell me what happened.
She didn't tell you about the vulture. The vulture just floated down like a little black saint and sat there on the edge of the pool and looked at Deva and just opened his wings and drank in the water, and then looked again and looked around, and he drank more in the water. He was just having a good time. He wasn't scared of Deva. He knew she was there, and we were watching him, but he felt it was okay. He knew what humans were like, so he was just drinking and taking his time to drink on the edge of the pool. That's the point. Was nice with the vulture. And then
the two birds that have their nest right above the pool in this fork of the tree, which you can see on the video, they saw it and they were like, no, we are going to tell you again that we don't want you here. So one of them came down really actually startled me how it came down to scare the vulture away. Didn't work, tried again, didn't work, and then both really kind of made their point and they all flew off together, and we all caught it on camera and you can see it in stories.
David Attenborough. David should come in, the David Attenborough of Costa Rica.
David Attenborough. So
I just feel like singing this song to you guys. Hope that's okay. I heard it today, and it made me want to sing it. By the rivers of Babylon, where we sat down, and there we wept when we remembered Zion. By the rivers of Babylon, where we sat down, carry us away, captivity, require from us a song. How can we sing King Alpha's song in a strange land? Of Babylon, where we sat down, and there we wept when we remembered Zion. Oh, the wicked carry us away, captivity require from us a song. Song in a strange land. So let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O of a sad song, but it makes you happy to sing it. It's one of those special songs. It's a sad song, but it raises the spirits. It's actually from the Bible, and I only know that because I really like the original version by a Jamaican group called the
Melodians,
yeah, Melodians, back in the 60s, and they did a great reggae version, and it's a beautiful song, isn't it? Anyway, welcome, here we go. Shall we go straight into the meditation?
Yes, let's go into our inner, spacious, free world with no restrictions, which includes all the sounds around us, and each sound is a gift for us to remember our inner freedom and our inner here and now, which is like the limitless sky. So beautiful, right, that we can have this space when we close our eyes, that there is.
What I like about that space is that it's ours. It's nobody else's. When you close your eyes, that's home. There's no, there's only you there. No governments, no religions, no anything can penetrate that. It's your own reality and our own freedom. So it's a beautiful space. That's why we meditate. It's to connect with our sense of freedom, whatever happens on the outside.
Mm.
That's what it is. So, you know, it's not easy. It's not cheap. You have to commit yourself. You have to be purposeful, you know. But it's worth it because it's a valuable gift that you give, that we give ourselves by committing to a meditation practice or committing ourselves to a mantra practice. These things where you step beyond your shadow and where we say yes, you know. And again, it seems like these times when we're in some kind of very enclosed situation, there's the only way out is in, as we can all say. I know it's a cliche, but it's actually true. So and can we just encourage you to make the effort, whatever it takes, to join us in this special sacred space today. And and thank you for joining us. We know now who we are. We're a family, and we see you, and we recognize you, and we're very grateful to you all to give us the incentive to do this. We would be doing it anyway, but it's a way to share with you, and so it's a double whammy, you know. Okay, so shall we prepare for the meditation? You start by getting our bodies comfortable, and by closing our eyes and slowly coming to a place of stillness. Take your time. Your body is just adjusting. Your spine is straight. We have this feeling of intention, and perspective of intention when we chant, and when we sit together in silence. Our silence is like reaching out and taking the hands of someone else in another land. And all around the planet we are beginning to take hands as we sit in the silence. Brothers and sisters, lovers and friends, and bringing a smile to our face and to our belly, and taking a deep breath. Take a nice deep breath, and then we'll just sit for a moment in silence before we chant. It's Today we will chant the Aum, which is the three sounds. David will lead us into the Aum sound. And then we will go from that mantra to the Gayatri Seven Chakra, where we locate and connect with all our seven chakras. This is an inner cleansing today, an inner cleansing. So enjoy. Bring your attention to the sounds in the room, the sounds around you.
Take a deep breath.
Sound of light with the ah sound into your body with the channel. And into the body with the sound. And then a deep breath. To receive the light and the ah sound, bringing them as a funnel and a channel into the body with the sound, and touching your body where you feel the resonance.
To stand up if you feel like, and just really use your whole body in this prayer. prayer and in this movement, whatever feels right, you can use your arms, you can move, put your hands on the chakras as we move
up. Give it up to God.
You can walk around your space like a prayer wheel. Whatever, the whole body is becoming the prayer and the dedication and the offering and the gratitude. So nice to spread the arms when we sing and to really let ourselves be totally with every fiber of our beings and our bodies, be part of it. And nobody's looking, so you can do whatever feels good, even more.
Each other across the world with our voices and our song and dance. Satyam.
sabitur varinam pargo diva si animae dio iuna praciodaya.
To the mantra, arm together. Closing our eyes, coming home. Connected across the world in these moments. Gratitude. And with a sense of forgiveness, forgiving ourselves and forgiving those around us who might have hurt us in some way. It's a good moment to forgive. lightens our load, makes us easier to fly. And as my good friend Vikas says, all things must pass. George Harrison said it and Vikas sang it. Thanks, Vikas. Okay, friends. Wow, that was beautiful today. Some of you asked, what was that song that I was playing when Deva got so angry in the ashram? Do you remember that story? I'm sure you do. If those of you who don't know that story, well, you missed. It's too long to tell you now, isn't it?
But you have to sing the actual song.
I'll play you the song, that a bit of the song anyway, that made Deva so angry because I was supposed to be in deep meditation in a state of non-doing, and Deva was lying on the bed in meditation in a state of non-doing, and my state of non-doing was to rise up from the bed and pick up my guitar, and it really disturbed Deva's meditation. That was in the early days. But what happened was she got so angry, but she didn't act upon it. She got so angry, it was a boiling ball of fire in her chest and in her belly, in her whole body. And she didn't do anything. She laid there and allowed it to transform itself into light. And she popped. And she just laid there in absolute bliss, because the energy of that anger was just energy. As soon as she didn't judge it or throw it out or judge herself, she just laid there in it until it just went pow. And meanwhile, Miten was sitting there on the balcony singing this song. You got to move, you got to move, you got to move, child, you got to move. And when the Lord gets ready, you got to move. Yeah, that's what I was saying. And she didn't move. He didn't move. He just was in. I looked over at the bed and it was like bright light. Oh. Shall we sing? Should we sing something? I must tell them.
No, sing something.
Broken hearts and broken wings, bring it all, bring everything. Bring the song you fear to sing, all is welcome here. And even if you broke your vow 1,000 times, come anyhow. Stepping into the power of now, and all is welcome here. La 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 la. I'm not talking geographically here. It's not so much that I would welcome a whole flock of vultures right now into this gathering. So it's not really, I'm talking about something that's not geographical. I'm talking about what we were experiencing earlier, the space of openness and the understanding that everything we hear is God's orchestra and it's coming to us as a gift. And that's what I'm talking about. In this space, everything is welcome because everything is a teaching. Some of the most difficult teachings, they come from being open. And that's what this song is about. And every character in the song is me. See the Father and the Son reunited, here they come. They're dancing to the sacred drum. They know they're welcome here. I see the shaman and the mighty priest. I see the beauty and the beast. Singing, I have been released, and I am welcome here. You sing together with me. La 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 la. Was too drunk on love to hesitate. To the winds I cast my fate and the remnants of my fear. Took a deep breath and I leapt, and I awoke as if I'd never slept. Tears of gratitude I wept. I was welcome. Busy lives, your careers, and bring the pain that you carried for years. All is welcome here. And freedom is not so far away. There's just the one price we all have to pay. Live those dreams till they fade away. And let them go. Live our dreams and let them fade away. And let them go. Live our dreams until they fade away. Yeah, and then let them go. All is welcome. And now. Here. And now.
Jacob Collier quote. That's what I mean when we sit in silence and sounds come. I remember a story that I heard once where Osho was helping one of his disciples to absorb the sound of dogs barking into her meditation, so that it became a part of the silence, not against the silence, not pushing against the silence, trying to invade, but actually it was part of the silence. These dogs were part
of her silence. And once she understood that, everything, you can meditate in, you know, you can meditate in the middle of Mumbai, totally silent inside. And every sound is not in any way disturbing or disruptive. Can you imagine? I've seen that.
We've experienced
it. I've experienced it for sure, but you know, like seeing enlightened Babas that are not affected in any way by the outside world, like beggars on the street, sadhus, monks with their begging bowls, you know. And this is our goal. Our Western civilization has distracted us and diverted us into all its riches and its abundance of possessions. It's incredible to be a white Westerner in this time, because we've had everything we want. Now it's changing. We're going to have to be looking inside for that nourishment. It's not outside. We'll find that. I know that from being in India. When you walk past some of those slums, you know, the deepest belly laughter you'll hear is there. People have a secret there. They can live in such an incredible time and still be happy, still be feeling abundance in their laughter. And that's our challenge, so that we can enjoy whatever riches come, but we can also enjoy whatever else is there. And we become silent and accepting and compassionate with ourselves and in love with ourselves and in love with our beloveds.
Thank you.
Would you like to sing something?
No, okay. I think this is good for today.
Shall we sing
Loka?
Loka to finish.
Loka Samosa.
You.
Sukhino bhavantu, loka samasta, sukhino bhavantu, loka samasta, sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti, shanti, shanti.
May all beings be happy. May all my thoughts, words, and actions contribute in some way to the happiness of all beings. Peace, peace. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you.